Okay, so here's something that's very interesting, and you may experience it if you come to Japan. Now, if you have children, you may experience this, and be prepared, be prepared. If you're coming to Japan and your children are 100% not Japanese, so they look different than a regular Japanese kid, or your kids are, you know, of a mixed marriage, mixed race, they look different, they're gonna stand out a bit. So here's something I noticed years ago, I've been dealing with it for years as a teacher. Now I used to be a kindergarten teacher, I'm not a kindergarten teacher anymore, but when I was a kindergarten teacher, you know, kindergarten kids are cute. Now, my students were all Japanese, but they're cute, right? So when you go out in public to places maybe like parks or big parks or tourist destinations, often you're gonna have, okay, so if it's a big tourist destination, you may have like visitors from another country where they don't kind of, where they think it's fine to just photograph anybody. And you'll have a lot of people trying to photograph the students or the kids or your kids. And I don't like strangers just walking up and taking pictures of my children. And as a teacher, it was a rule. Like, we were not allowed to let people take pictures of our students for privacy reasons, obviously. We're in charge of their safety and whatnot. And if people did take pictures, we'd have to tell them to stop and we'd have to tell them to delete the photo. And sometimes it would turn into arguments. Most people were very understanding, but we'd just like, you can't take these, you know, the picture. I'm a teacher here. These are my students. You need to delete that picture. but one thing I've noticed over the years, a lot of retirees, a lot of pensioners, people in Japan, when they retire, like to, you know, take on a hobby, painting, drawing. A lot, they take on photography, and a lot of old people, and they don't mean anything, there's no malice here, there's nothing malicious, but they'll be looking around, they're looking around for something to take a picture of, and they see your kids, and they're like, oh, cute, and they'll try to take a picture of your kid with like a big giant zoom lens, right up close. So I don't like that just because people don't ask for permission. Now that's one thing I know, like, professional photographers often will do is they'll ask people for permission to take a photo, and if not, they're not allowed to. Okay. Or professional photographers, for example, will have like name cards with them, business cards, and they will ask people, can I take a picture of your child? Can I take a picture of this? And then present the name card. And again, if they say no, there. If not, and if they're okay with it, all right, cool. But people, I found in Japan, don't ask for permission. They just think it's okay to take a picture of someone else's child. At least in my experience. So today we're waiting outside of the American consulate with for my friend who's inside, and there's myself, my wife, my friend's fiance, and my kids outside. And I saw this big photography club coming along, and right away I turned into a teacher instantly. I'm like, boom! I was kind of like standing in front of my kids, trying to make like a wall, kind of block them. And I could see the people looking around, looking for something to take pictures. And sure, just like I said, when I told my wife, I'm just gonna stand in front of the kids here because I think some of these people are gonna try to take pictures of my kids. And sure enough, instantly I saw that a few people like look at my kids, notice them, tap like their friends in the arms and point, and then I saw like cameras come up to start taking pictures of my kids, and I just looked at them and I did like this like arms crossed motion, and I was like, and then they went and they kind of put their cameras down and walked away. Yeah, just, I mean, like, so I'm into photography these days, but I take, you know, wildlife photography, you know, maybe I should be asking bees and mantises and grasshoppers and birds for the permission to take photos, but I don't. Mostly because I can't speak their language very well, but yeah, if I were to want to take like stills of people or photos of people, I would approach them, I suppose, and try to ask them if I could and for what reason. But I don't plan on getting into photography of people aside from like my family and friends. But yeah, so it's interesting, just something to think about, to be aware of when you come to Japan, especially if you're with kids. It might be common for people to try, if you're in big touristy areas where there's a lot of people with cameras, or you're somewhere like at Hanami time, the cherry blossom viewing time, and there's a lot of people with cameras, they may see your kids, your family, your students, if you're a teacher, and try to take their pictures. And if you are a teacher, depending on what kind of school you work at, but you're probably going to be told to be vigilant and make sure people do not take photos of your students, because I mean, in the past, I've had students who had parents who were celebrities and stuff like that. So you know, they you got to be really careful, you know, when they're your own children, I think you're probably going to be even more careful. So there you go, guys. Something interesting about photography in Japan. All right, guys, check the links below. See ya.